Do virtual plants have DNA?
No!
Because the real DNA in plants is one very long molecule made of atoms. And there is no time to simulate all this. I'm making an evolution simulation of a plant ecosystem. My virtual plants don't have real DNA, but I still need a way to describe how they grow, reproduce, and die. I will be looking at real plants for reference, and come up with a way to describe a plant's shape and behavior with a very simple model. Well, maybe not that simple. I need a new model, similar to DNA, with a list of instructions to grow the plant. While researching for the new plant design, I have been working on Alien Plants Explorer. It will be version 2 of Alien Plants, still using the same simple plants, but with improvements to explore and interact with the simulation. Features like movement, placing new seeds, adjusting the speed of the simulation, phylogenetic tree, a soil control, or a map view. Creating the new model for plants is a long-term challenge, and there will be lots of failed experiments along the way. These are my design goals for the new plant model. Instruction-based means the plant grows to its final form by following a list of orders instead of having fixed traits in a predefined plant template. The instructions can be like a program running code that results in a plant, or they can be like a blueprint describing the morphology itself. For example, create 3 small leaves, then 1 big seed. I want to achieve a bit of both, but I'd prefer the DNA to be easy to understand and to see the connection with the developed plant. When it comes to the building blocks of a plant, I prefer to avoid using explicit parts like root, fruit, or petals, because the plants could just use these pre-made patterns instead of evolving a solution by themselves. After some thinking, I'm confident I can get a lot with only 3 parts, or segments as I like to call them. A structural segment, which can become a stem, branch, root, petals, or even new parts that don't exist in real plants. A leaf segment, which is actually very specific, but photosynthesis is very representative of plants and it's a complex process at the molecular level, and I prefer to coat leaves directly and avoid unnecessary complexity. And anyway, I'm sure the simulation will find new ways to use this part. And the third one is the fruit flower seed. I have yet to decide an official name, but it's basically a DNA container that can start a new plant. It could also act as pollen, spores, pistil, or even new organs for communication between plants. The basic functions of plants are defined by biochemistry. A complete biochemistry model would be very complex. That's why in my simulation I need to make a compromise and create predefined rules that won't evolve. Some behaviors are specific to a type of segment, so for example, structures transport water and glucose, leaves perform photosynthesis based on color, seeds can alter or fix DNA, and for every segment, every action has an energy cost. I expect all of this added complexity to create plants that are more diverse and better adapt to the environment, but complexity alone won't make the plants evolve in interesting ways. Even in a sea of possibilities, there only may be a few viable configurations. In the previous video we saw plants always converge into neoplastic proliferation, and every run will always end the same way. Convergent evolution also happens in reality. For example, eyes have evolved multiple times in unrelated species. It's a recurring pattern, a viable solution to a common problem. In my search for a DNA model for alien plants, I will have to identify quickly if convergent evolution is a sign of healthy diversity and adaptation, or the result of bad design. If you want to know more about convergent evolution, I recommend you to watch this video by Isaac Arthur. Now, to achieve these goals, it's time to start looking at real plants. Designing DNA for virtual plants is going to be a big challenge. There are technical limitations, and will the plants look good? How to make them react to their ecosystem and make it easy to understand? Some tweak will break everything, or the plants may not look like plants at all. My next goal is to keep working on Alien Plants Explorer, and in the meantime I want to make more videos about alien plants and artificial evolution. Making this video was a bit difficult because I don't know exactly who's watching and how much can I go into details, so I will be answering all the questions and suggestions in the comments below. Have a nice day!